Fly me to the moon. Let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, baby, kiss me.
Welcome to another episode of Honeymooning in Honduras. I'm Nicole Martyr, and this week, Gabby and Marcio go back to mainland Honduras to the port city of La Ceiba. We took the afternoon ferry from Roatan to La Ceiba, a long but pleasant trip aboard the Galaxy boat. We finally arrived at the hotel at around 6:30 in the afternoon, when Gabby and Marcio had a Pico Bonito-style welcome with delicious food cocktails served in exotic coconut shell cups. Staying at the lodge at Pico Bonito is a true ecological experience, located just a couple of minutes from La Ceiba in the buffer zone of the Pico Bonito National Park and Rainforest, one of the largest and most important natural reserves in the country. This Eco Lodge offers its visitors a wide variety of nature-discovering activities and experiences. Just a walk from the hotel's front desk to the cabins in the middle of the forest is already quite an experience, especially if you arrive when it's already dark, like we did. When Gabby and Marcia opened the door of their cabin, they were simply marveled. The whole place was surrounded by trees and plants, which they could contemplate from their hammock in their terrace. Inside, they found a beautifully decorated room with an astonishing bed, a reading chair, and exquisite wooden furniture. Two beautiful white robes and slippers were placed on the bed for the newlyweds to use during their stay, which they later on took with them as a souvenir. A delicious, exotic, fresh-from-the-garden food basket was placed in their cabin, along with a bottle of red wine. Since we were only staying in La Ceiba for one night, Gabby and Marcia wanted to spend the night in the town. So we all headed back to downtown La Ceiba for a quick tour and a typical carnitas dinner, which we all enjoyed with a local beer. When the evening was over, Marcio had decided he loved Honduran cuisine. Finally, it was time to rest from a long trip and get ready for the next day's activities. Surrounded by complete tranquility, interrupted only by the roar of the river, you can experience such a deep sleep that you risk the chance of not wanting to get up the next day, which is exactly what happened to us in the morning. After a delicious fresh breakfast prepared at the Pico Bonito restaurant next to the garden, Marcio was enjoying relaxation so much he decided he would take it easy for the rest of our time at Pico Bonito. So the man stayed back at the hotel relaxing while Gabby and I put on our adventure shoes to walk one of the many nature trails in the park. Due to the short time we had, we decided to do one of the shorter guided trails. We met our guide, Carlos, at the hotel's front desk, where he gave us a brief explanation and safety instructions. Gabby and I looked at each other and were glad we took a guided tour instead of exploring the park on our own. Soon we were off and stopping at almost every flower we saw. Gabby is a true nature lover, so she really enjoyed every bit of information Carlos had about every flower, plant, insect, and animal she stopped to photograph. After climbing the bird-watching tower, walking the nature trail, and stopping to admire every amazing detail you can find in the rainforest, we finally arrived at Las Pilas. We took the slippery path down the river, where the sight was simply jaw-dropping. The roar of the water rushing through the rocks was thrilling. Carlos showed us two pilas, or ponds, where Gabby was the first to get in. The water was completely clear and pure, so much we could even see our toes from above, and needless to say, it was amazing. As you can imagine, the water was freezing, but astonishingly refreshing and rejuvenating. Without even looking for it, I think we found the Fountain of Youth. You simply feel full of energy and peace when you get out of the water. It was a delightful sensation of completion and purity. Definitely the highlight of our trip. Once back at the hotel with the men, we all enjoyed a delicious pico bonito late lunch together. Then we packed our bags and said goodbye to this ecological treasure, but not before visiting the hotel's serpentine and butterfly garden, where we got to learn a lot about these fascinating creatures and their lifestyle. And Gabby tried her best to take pictures of the colorful butterflies. With a long road trip ahead, we left La Ceiba and the lodge at Pico Bonito behind to discover new worlds in the other side of Honduras.